We'll now look at the formal structure of logical operators. And in the previous video, we talked about some of those. We said and, not, if, then. And now we are going to see how that is formalized in mathematical terms. So the first one we are going to see is the logical negation. And you see that there are a couple of different notations to represent not. We have that strange sign there. I don't even know how to explain where it is. And we can also use the tilt. The English translation of the negation is not something. For instance, the negation of I speak English is I do not speak English. If we have a proposition P and that proposition is true, the negation of P is going to be false. And if we have a proposition P and that P is false, the negation of that of P, not P, is going to be true. So not transforms true in false and false in true. Then we have the logical disjunction. The symbol looks like a V, and it's translated as or, but in the sense that it's and or. For instance, I'm enrolling in the business degree, proposition P. Proposition Q is I'm enrolling in the cybersecurity degree. The disjunction of these two propositions will be P or Q, I'm enrolling in the business degree or in the cybersecurity degree. On the right side of your screen, you have what we call a truth table for P or Q, which is basically all the possibilities. P can be either true or false, and if P is true, Q can be true or false, and if P is false, Q can be true or false. The disjunction is true if at least one of them is true. So the first three lines contain at least one true, and the disjunction is going to be true in those cases. The disjunction will only be false, corresponding to a lie, if both P and Q are false. So this sentence, I'm enrolling in the business degree or in the cybersecurity degree, is only false if I don't enroll neither in business degree or in cybersecurity degree. If I enroll in one of them or in both, then I'm not lying. This is different from the logical exclusive disjunction, which those of you enrolled in cybersecurity degrees or software development degrees will come to know as XOR. This type of operations is extremely relevant, especially in cryptology. A couple of different notations for the exclusive disjunction: a V with a dot on top of it, a plus surrounded by a circle, or the three letters XOR. It's translated as either this or that, meaning that one of them must be true, but not both of them simultaneously. Some examples: if P is I'm enrolling in the computer forensics degree, and Q is I'm enrolling in the software development degree, P, XOR Q, is going to be either I'm enrolling in the computer forensics degree or in the software development degree, meaning that certainly not in both together. And the XOR is going to be true if one of them is true and the other one is false, and is going to be false in both cases, other two cases. So if I enroll in the computer forensics degree and also in the software development degree, I was lying when I said it's either one or the other. If I don't enroll in any of those, I'm also lying when I say I'm going to enroll in either one or the other. The only situations where I'm not lying is if I enroll in just one of them. And you see on the right side of the screen, the truth table for the XOR with two propositions. We also have the logical conjunction. The notation is upside down V, and we read it as AND. For instance, I'm enrolling in the accounting degree and in the integrated studies degree. This is only true if both the situations are true. And so if one of them is false, or if both of them are false, I'm lying. And so the conjunction or the AND is false if at least one of them is false. That's what you have in the truth table that you have there. And of course, the advantage of having videos is that you can pause at any time and spend as much time as you need looking at the truth tables and getting comfortable with them. The logical implication, the notation is an arrow pointing from left to right, and it's translated as if something, then something. For instance, if P is I'm retiring in August, and Q is I'm enrolling in a master's degree, the P implicates Q is if I'm retiring in August, then I'm enrolling in a master's degree. And the only situation where an implication is false is when the proposition on the left is true and the proposition on the right is false. That's the second line of that truth table that you have on the right side of the screen. If both of them are true, if I retire in August and then I enroll in a master's degree, then clearly I did not lie. Some people get a little bit confused about what happens if I do not retire in August. Well, if I do not retire in August, I didn't say anything about that. I didn't say what I would do if I do not retire in August. So clearly, I'm not lying, because either I can enroll, not enroll. I promised nothing about the situation where I do not retire. So if P is false, no matter what Q is, the implication is still going to be true. And then we have the logical equivalence. The symbol is an arrow pointing, so a line with arrows pointing in both directions, and the translation is if and only if. And applying to the same situation, this would be I'm retiring in August if and only if I'm enrolling in a master's degree. And in this situation, it's true if I retire in August and I enroll in a master's degree, or if I don't retire in August and I don't enroll in a master's degree. So if both are true, or if both are false, my equivalence is true. If one of them is true and the other is false, my equivalence is false.